Tom Libous reports to you. Fighting to keep state spending under control. Exploring new options for economic growth and jobs for our communities. Helping our kids succeed by encouraging them to read and stay away from drugs and alcohol.
Hi, you're watching Tom Libous Reports to You. I'm Julia Locandy. Today, Senator Libous is here today because he wants to talk to you about money. Your money, how it plays out in education, community advancement, and you also have something that you want to tell them how they can find money that they may not even know they have.
I did.
Yeah. So, okay, let's start with education, though, because, you know, it's been a really big week for education advocacy here in New York Senate. How were you involved this week?
We have been fighting for upstate schools. It's been kind of a theme. You know, I've gone to a number of meetings throughout my district that the teachers, students, administrators put on, and each case we've been talking about the plight of upstate rural schools and the difficulty they've been having. There was a rally just recently in Albany, and I went to that rally and I spoke very passionately about how we need to help our upstate schools, how we need to make up some of the funding discretions that are there, and that I would work with them and my upstate colleagues to do what we can. You know, in my district of Broome, Tioga, and Chenango County, I have many rural schools, and the rural schools are having a very, very difficult time. When they have to cut programs, these programs are, you know, major programs, unlike some of the wealthy districts who can cut, you know, some programs that they really don't need. So we need more money for our upstate schools, and that's what I've been advocating for.
So it's just a way of rethinking the way it's distributed.
Yes, the budget's tight, and we agree with Governor Cuomo that we want to keep spending under control, and that's what I've done the last 2 years, going to do it again this year. But what I am saying is there's a $250 million challenge grant portion of the budget that the governor would like to use for grants. I'm for challenge grants. I think that's good. I think you can inspire people to go after those grants and to do better educationally. But before we do challenge grants, we have to make sure that upstate schools have the fair share that they deserve and that they need to function educationally before we get into challenge grants. So I want to take that $250 million and I'd like to put it into upstate rural schools.
Right. So the I've heard you say time and time again, kids come first.
They do.
So the evaluation system that's being put in place. Tell me how you feel about that.
Well, that's a good system. It's something that we worked with the governor on and certainly worked with the teachers and all the educators in New York State to put together a comprehensive evaluation system that ultimately is going to improve the quality of education. And that's really what this is all about. Our goals are to improve education. We have some great educators here in the Southern Tier. We have people who are very committed to what they do. I think for the most part, the evaluation system is going to be more helpful in other parts of the state, but it will be helpful here. And it's only to better education. It's about helping our teachers do the job that they need to do to educate our kids. And, you know, if we all work together and everybody's dedicated, you know, like any profession, you hear the bad stories from time to time. But I'm pretty proud of the school districts here in the Southern Tier and certainly the people who work in them and the folks who teach in them.
Yeah, so good teachers shouldn't have anything to worry about.
That's right.
Yeah. So I am on tomlibous.com all the time because I'm just checking out things to talk to you about.
Everything's there.
Yeah, and I noticed that you talk to school boards a lot, and you're always talking to parents. So how do they feel about this?
They're pretty much in line. They're very pleased with the fact that I'm going to bat for education in rural schools. They support the teacher evaluation system. They're in place. They like what they're seeing in New York State. They like the leadership of the governor and the fact that we're willing to work with him and get things done. It's all about results. It's not about dysfunction anymore. You know, as I've said to you on this program, Washington has terrible dysfunction. New York State is getting things done. We're going to continue to get things done, working with the governor. And I think parents, students, school boards, they're happy. Look, they all need more money. It's a tough time. The last 4 or 5 years have been very difficult, but we have to do what's right. We have to shrink the size of government and operation before we can start improving it.
Absolutely, and that's what it's about.
It is.
So speaking of education funding, the lottery and video casinos around the state contribute to New York's education funding. And a report recently came out about the economic impact of Tioga Downs in Nichols. So can you tell us about that?
28 and a half, let's use 29 to round it up because we like to round things up, at $29 million in Tioga County because of Tioga Downs, the economic impact. It's been a great boon for the county and the region. You know, you have 249 jobs at Tioga Downs. You have 612 other jobs that have accumulated around the community. It's been fantastic. People like it. It's a destination. It's entertainment. It's fun. It's something to do, and it's an economic builder. We knew this when I worked with Jeff Gorrell, the owner. Julia, the beautiful thing about Tioga Downs is the owner invested over $35 million. He didn't ask for a nickel of state money. He invested over $35 million of his own money. Mm-hmm. You know, here's a beautiful scene behind us, or that was behind us, that shows the race, the racing aspect of Tioga Downs, which is going to open up again, I think, on Kentucky Derby Day, as it has every year. There, the crowd is having a good time, and the grandstands are full. So It's a destination point for entertainment. It's also a economic engine. Now, we want to take it a step further and approve casino gambling. One of the things that I'll ask people to do here is, if you're watching this program, go on tomlibous.com, take our survey about casino gambling. Let us know what you feel about casino gambling. Do you think it's something New York State should do? Should we change the Constitution and have table games at Tioga Downs? I'm anxious to hear from you, and I think that's very important.
I know people are talking to you about this, so what are they saying? For the most part.
Well, you know, it's very interesting. When I talk about gaming or table games at Tioga Downs, probably 75% of the folks that I talk to think it's a fabulous idea, we should do it. If you talk about gaming in general and that you're going to do it just anywhere in the state, people say, no, that's not a good idea, and I happen to agree with that. So I want to hear what my constituents say about table games at Tioga Downs, casino gaming in general. If they go on tomlibous.com, they can let me know that.
Very good. And, you know, back to the education, of the $27 million that Tioga Downs generated, more than $21 million went to education, so that's beautiful.
It goes into education. That's the beauty of the racinos. The money does go into education. It helps offset what taxpayers would have to pay. Mm-hmm. You know, I always get asked the question about the lottery, and, you know, New York State spends about $21 billion in education. The lottery brings in probably a couple of billion, so that's the big difference. People think the lottery was supposed to pay for education. Maybe that was promised at one time, long before you and I came on the scene, but it accounts for about $2 billion of the $21 billion, so there's a big gap in between.
Right, very good. So, okay, so now let's talk about the possibility of having money, of our viewers having money out there, and they don't even know about it.
Unclaimed funds. I didn't know about this myself until someone told me that they were on the unclaimed funds on the state comptroller's website. He shows where the unclaimed funds are that people have. Some, by the way, $10 billion in New York State. Think about that. $10 billion of unclaimed funds. So I want to help people who are watching this program and throughout my district to find those dollars that belong to them.
Right, and it's just a simple search.
It's a simple search, yep.
Yep, you put in your name, and you have a link to that on your website, tomlibous.com.
We tried to make it more convenient. If you go to tomlibous.com, we'll take you right to the unclaimed funds section. You can put your name in, and you'd be surprised. I got $75. Apparently,
really?
When I was in college in Utica back many, many years ago, there was some sort of an account that I had that went to unclaimed funds, and I filled out the paperwork, I sent it in, and I got my $75 check. So it's kind of nice. It was found money.
That is very interesting to know.
Yeah, and I think, you know, we've had examples of people who've called the office, too, and we've directed them there. And you'd be surprised. You know, what happens is banks, utility companies build up credits, you know, different things that you forget about, or if you move and maybe there was an account somewhere and people actually forget, you know, they opened a savings account, maybe there's a couple $100 in it, they forget about it. These are those unclaimed funds, and the state of New York is going to help you get it back.
Right, and it seems very easy, and I think I'm going to do it this evening.
Check your name, and you can go on TomLibous.com and go right to the unclaimed funds section. I think it's fabulous. I would encourage everybody who's watching this program to go to TomLibous.com, go to unclaimed funds, and see if you have a small fortune there waiting for you.
Yeah, and does it cost anything to do?
No, not at all. Not at all. Just time. It takes you some time. You print out the paperwork if you have money there, and I filled it out, sent it in, and it's pretty cool. You can do it right online.
Yeah, I know how it feels to find money and
it's nice.
a winter jacket that you just didn't know about
it's
or anything,
nice.
But
it's
to find
nice.
Some money like that.
We had one situation with unclaimed funds, Julia, where a gentleman's his mother passed away. He was entitled to the estate. And I guess there was some also additional money that she had coming to her in unclaimed funds, so he was able to get that in that case. So,
very nice.
Yeah. Everybody should check. Go on TomLibous.com, go to unclaimed funds, check it out. You may have a fortune waiting for you.
Nice. Last time you were in, you talked about a bill that would impact the private sector businesses, the annual pay notice mandate. The Senate voted yesterday to repeal that bill. Can you explain again what it'll mean?
It is one of the biggest burdens on business that was imposed, by the way, and I remind people that I voted against it originally. I think we talked about that. It requires employers, every employer in the state, if you have one employee, if you're self-employed, to provide just tons of information on your employees, and it's just a burdensome nightmare. We voted to repeal that. The Business Council came out yesterday and applauded us, said that it's another one of those business mandates that the state Senate was willing to remove. I supported the legislation yesterday, and we need to give business the tools to create jobs, create energy, create economic stimulus, not to make them report more. And that's it's a bad bill. The Senate repealed it. Now we need the Assembly to take action.
Very good. And another thing that's going on right now, legislative leaders met with economists for revenue projections for the budget. It is March 1st. The budget is due on April 1st.
We're going to have an on-time budget again. I really believe that. We're working very hard to do that. 2 years in a row, I think, sends a real strong message to the folks that we represent. We have revenue estimates. You know, the economy is getting a little better in New York. We've got a long way to go. We're showing that revenues may be a little better than what the governor proposed. In my opinion, though, that doesn't mean we can go spend the money.
Right.
I think you need to just keep fiscal restraint, keep reducing spending, keep doing the things that we're doing, and if the revenues continue to increase, then we'll have a little extra money to deal with next year. And it's always good to have money for a rainy day.
Right, so the next step is to pass the One House bills?
Yeah, we're going to do One House bill. We do an internal process, as you know, right now that looks at every aspect of the budget. I'm obviously intimately involved in that. We'll come up with a resolution. It's called our Senate One House resolution. The Assembly will do the same. We'll pass those resolutions very soon, in about 10 days, and then we go to what we call conference committees so that we can begin negotiating the budget in public and getting it done. I'm confident that we can get an on-time budget done again this year.
Explain a little bit more about the conference committees, because people say that it isn't always done, but it was something that was put in place in 2007, but it just wasn't done.
I actually was a member of that reform committee who came up with this great reform, and basically it's the Senate and the Assembly come together, and there's committees that are divided up, and we negotiate the different education committee will negotiate education pieces, criminal justice, crime pieces, and they're discussed in a public forum. The media's there, and the public has full access and information to many of the things that are going to go into the budget. So it's a good thing.
Right, and it's important to keep it in the public.
Got to keep it public.
In the public eye.
Yeah. And we do that by going on TomLibous.com.
Yes, always.
Thanks.
Always. Thanks so much for being with us, Senator.
Always a pleasure.
Thank you so much for watching Tom Libous Reports to You. For any additional information, don't forget to log on to TomLibous.com to check to see if you have some money coming to you. It's also a good source for community events and updates on legislation.